Today I'm going to discuss with you one mantra chanted daily can actually change your attitude about life. See, in Hinduism, actually death is not perceived as a threat or, you know, as a punishment. It is actually considered as a moment of transformation or moving into the next dimension. It's just about shedding our physical body and moving on. Okay, life continues actually for us. That is why we never say RIP in Hinduism. What we say is may his soul get sadgati, or you know, may his soul get moksha. That is what we say. We never say RIP. RIP is a very Western concept, and it is actually, you know, like you will be... I'm not very comfortable with this RIP. You should never write that, because according to Hinduism, our soul never never rests in peace. All right. So actually our Atma is eternal. Lord Krishna also has said the same thing in Bhagavad Gita. He says, Jatasya Maranam Dhruvam. So what do we mean by this? It means whatever is born, whether it's a plant or animal or human beings, whatever is born has to die or perish. So we have no control over our birth. We have no control over our death. Whatever in between period is there, we have to manage. That is why he gives a complete karma yoga is there. And that's a very wide and a vast topic in Bhagavad Gita. Very relevant and even to this day. So we can certainly control our actions or karma and then make this life meaningful. Now, this meaningful shloka actually must be included in our daily prayers. I'm not very sure of its origin, but somewhere I read that Vidura, a famous character from Mahabharata, used to chant this mantra daily, what I'm going to share with you today. And in that case, like, you know, if it is appearing in Mahabharata, obviously, you know, Maharshi Vedavasa must have written it. But I'm really not sure about that. I have heard my grandfather and father chanting this daily. And I learned it as a child only. But I couldn't make a lot of sense at that time. Now I'm able to connect and reflect and understand what it means. And, you know, the shloka goes like this. Anayasena maranam. Vina dainena jivanam. Dehatyage tavasanithyam. Dehime purushottama. Or dehime parameshwara. Now let us understand the purport of this. What is the meaning of this shloka? Anayasena maranam. See, every one of us should pray for easy death. What do I mean by easy death? It means without prolonged illness, without prolonged sickness, and without troubling others. See, whenever somebody is on bed and, you know, for some things like we have to serve them on the bed or whatever, or due to prolonged illness, of course, it's a very painful experience for the entire family. It's not about doing something for them, but your own father, your own mother, or whatever, like, relations. To the active person who brought you up or who did, all the elders, whatever I mean, to see them suffering itself is a very, very painful thing. Plus, physically also you get exhausted. So our prayer should be, and just think of it, we feel we are doing something for them. Our pain is different. But think of that person who is, you know, taking all the service from you, how that person must be feeling. So easy death means you should just move on. I would love the way, like, you know, Sir APJ Kalam, you know, died. In fact, he was lecturing somewhere and he literally died in his books. What a death to come. So all of us should wish for such kind of death. So that is what we mean by anayasena maranam. Now, vina dainena jivana. Dainya is pity, or, you know, asking for some help or whatever. So this simply means that one should be self-sufficient and self-reliant without spreading our hands to anybody or without troubling others. You have to manage your own affairs. That's vina dainena jivanam. Dehatyage tavasanithyam. deha tyage means when I leave this sharira or leave this body, I want your presence. Whose presence? Lord's presence. So when I leave this body, I want to be with you, or O Paramatma, I just want to merge unto you. So dehi me purushottama. So give me such an opportunity, or Parameshwara. Now we have two main sects, Vaishnavites who are Aradhakas of Vishnu, Krishna, whatever form you take, and all the Dashavataras. And on the other hand, we have a Shaivite sect who follow Shaivism, that is, who are Aradhaka of Shiva and different forms of Shiva. So generally, all the Vaishnavites, you know, address to the Lord as Purushottama, Purusho me Uttam. So Purushottama, they say. And Shaivites, every time, whatever form of Shiva they worship, they say Parameshwar. So whatever is your faith, you can say. And this is actually, like, you know, I came across this shloka being circulated in WhatsApp. And it mentions that you have to chant it sitting on the temple when you are moving out of the temple, sit on the steps and chant it. But as far as my knowledge goes, my logic goes, or my thinking and understanding goes, why only in a temple once a while? How many of us go to temple daily? We are not going. This should be, in fact, a part of our daily prayer. And trust me, it gives immense peace and really, really, like, you know, it's a very peaceful experience. I've been doing it for years now. And earlier, I never understood much of the meaning. It was a routine. Now, with feelings and with understanding, I chant. So, I hope you like this information. If you like this video, then, you know, like, share and subscribe. Thank you. God bless.